Hello, and welcome to this session on production for SAP Business One. During this session, you will see the following: how SAP Business One handles production requirements, material requirement planning, MRP, production orders, bills of materials, and resources. With the latest release of SAP Business One, many new features and enhancements have been introduced to manage complete production cycles from acquisition of raw materials through production processes to stocking finished goods. By accessing the main menu for SAP Business One and drilling into sales and opening up an existing sales order, we can very easily determine that there is a shortfall of stock against this order. By scrolling across, we can see the details of the available stock for this item on the order. By then drilling through on the item code, we can see the associated bill of materials and also drill into the item master record itself. By then clicking on the inventory data tab, we can see further details on the stock levels for this item. Additionally, we can see that there is a shortfall listed for the stock level. By drilling into the planning data tab, we can also see the procurement method is set to make and it is planned through the MRP. We can now close the windows and navigate back into the main menu of SAP Business One. Now that we know the shortfall of stock needs to be handled by production, we know an order needs to be raised. But how is this best handled? Well, we have a number of options available, and quite simply we could go to the production menu and manually create a new production order, as long as we have the authorization to do this. A manual production order is easily generated, pulling through the bill of materials linked to the item, and we just need to put in a due date for the production order to be completed. However, this may not be the best way of handling the requirement. With SAP Business One, the tools to easily understand requirements for production and then suggest production orders that can be created to fulfill those requirements are provided in the core solution. On the main menu, we can see an option called MRP. MRP stands for Material Requirement Planning. This module provides a number of tools that will look at stock levels, requirements, scenarios, and other factors to suggest documents that could be generated to replenish production or even purchasing requirements. In this example, we can see the one production item has been selected to run through the MRP wizard across multiple locations, with certain other factors included here which relate to sales documents, stock levels, and so on. In the results window, we can see that the MRP has generated recommendations for us to view. In order to view these recommendations, we simply navigate into the MRP menu, click on Order Recommendations, ensure that the details are correct, and then simply click on OK. The order recommendation window is launched. We can see that it has a production order listed for the item that has a shortfall in stock. By scrolling across, we can see details of how many are recommended to be ordered, how they are being produced, and also details of when the order needs to be fulfilled by. On the far left-hand side, we can see a checkbox underneath the title Create. Simply just tick and then click on Update. This will then automatically create the production order required. A pop-up window will then tell us that the order has been created successfully. Click on OK, and we can close the windows. If we simply click back onto the production menu, and then click on production order, we can bring up the last production order that's been created. By launching this production order, we can see all of the details from the bill of materials that have been pulled through onto the production order. This includes all of the related information that was added for text and resource in addition to items for raw materials. By then clicking on the icon for print preview, we can also see the print document as it would appear when generated. This is using the fully integrated Crystal reports for SAP Business One. By clicking on the product number drill down through the orange arrow, we can navigate to the bill of materials associated with this product. Full details of all of the components, resources, and any labor used for production of the item are listed in detail here. If we're happy with the production order details, we can go to the status, drop down, choose release, and click on update. Additionally, we can also drill in to review some of the details of the components or resources by clicking on the orange arrow. This will take us through to the related master data record. Like other master data, the resources store details of all of the required information, for example capacity, where we can drill in to see further information around the availability or planning, where we can also factor this according to the number of resources that are available. By drilling through from the production order to the labour resource, we can assess further information relating to the available capacity, but also look at the planning data for labour resource. Additionally, in here, we can also see how many hours and how many people are available based on factors. For example, 8 hours per day with 2 people available. As with other areas of SAP Business One, production has its own reporting area associated with it. We can drill through, for example, into an open item list that will list all of the currently open production orders. At any point during this listing, we can use the orange arrows to simply drill into the transactional information for further details. For additional reporting requirements, the fully integrated crystal reports can be used for this. This concludes the session on SAP Business One production. Many thanks for watching. I hope you found this useful.